Hello students, in today's session we'll understand about formation of earth and also how that single cell is formed inside that water.
Origin of earth and its primitive atmosphere. Students, the origin of life on the earth is closely related with origin of earth. Evidences suggest that earth came into existence near about 4.6 billion years ago. Okay, Earth came into existence near about 4.6 billion years ago. So when it was broken from the sun, the Earth was broken from the sun. It was broken. So it was like a glowing fireball. Okay, the earth was like a fireball, it was rotating. This fireball was rotating cloud of hot gases. There were many hot gases, vapors of different elements, pieces of rocks and metals. All these were called as nebulous, N-E-B-U-L-O-U-S, nebulous. So these pieces of rocks and metals, were called as nebulous. And this mass of gas exploded with big bang into several small pieces. So the earth as a piece was broken from the sun. As the earth was moving away from the sun, its temperature, it slowly decreased, and this led into condensation of gases. Okay, so the heavy elements like nickel, then iron, they were heavy elements. Now we are understanding how earth was formed, its structure. So when it was broken from the sun, it was rotating hot gases, and as it started moving away from the sun, the temperature started decreasing, and then condensation of that elements and gases takes place. So the heavy elements which were condensed, they sank into the center, and in this way center of the earth the center of earth was formed, and it was a solid core which was made up of iron and nickel. Okay, so the core of the earth was made up of iron and nickel. Now the lightest elements which were made up of gases like helium, then hydrogen, then oxygen, these, and again other gases apart from these, there were other gases, nitrogen was there, yes, and one of the lightest element, carbon, was also present at that time. But this carbon, it was not in purest form. It made compound with oxygen, with hydrogen, and in the form of methane, carbon dioxide. This carbon was present. Oxygen was also, when at higher temperature, this oxygen, it always reacts with nitrogen. So this oxygen was also present in the form of compounds, carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, then compounds of nitrogen, NO2, NO, like such compounds. So these gases were present at that time. Okay. So which gases were present in the atmosphere? Hydrogen, helium, oxygen, nitrogen. Okay. Oxygen, nitrogen and carbon, they form compounds. Which compounds, which gases? They form gases like CO2, CO, NO2, NO. Okay. Then this carbon, again methane gas was present. So all these gases, they form atmosphere of the earth. From this we get idea that geological condition was different than the present atmosphere. Okay, during that time oxygen was not free because of high temperature. So that time the atmosphere was considered as reducing atmosphere. Nowadays it is oxidizing atmosphere. What is meant by reducing atmosphere? At that time, due to high temperature, oxygen gas was not free. It was available only in the form of compounds. Okay, so at that time oxygen gas was not freely available. Hence that type of environment was called as reducing type of environment. All that about atmosphere and center, that is core, I explained, was called as prebiotic environment. What is meant by prebiotic? Prebiotic means before the formation of living thing. Prebiotic, it was a prebiotic environment. At that time this hydrogen was present in abundance and it was very active. The atoms, as the earth was having very high temperature, so it was difficult for the atoms to combine with each other and to react with each other. At that time hydrogen was very active, so due to high temperature it always combined with nitrogen and it was present in the form of ammonia. So it reacted with oxygen and it was present in the form of H2O vapors. The hot vapors of water is called as steam. So it was present in the form of steam. So it reacted with carbon and it was present in the form of methane. So these gases, ammonia and methane, were in the form of gases at that time, while H2O was in the form of hot vapor. Hot vapor means steam. So as the time passes, the temperature of the earth cools down. When it cools down, the steam, it underwent condensation. The steam, okay, and water was formed. Now due to the presence of water, what happened? The temperature on the earth cooled down and this water, it gradually accumulated. Okay, as it gradually accumulated, there were streams, lakes, rivers were formed on the earth. Now we understood about the geographic, we are understanding now how that rivers were formed, streams were formed, lakes were formed. Okay, so these free radicals, they get condensed due to cool temperature and they form saturated and unsaturated hydrocarbons. So under the influence of available energy sources, so during that period the energy sources available on the earth were sun's rays. Which were the sun's rays? Ultraviolet rays. We know that at that time ozone gas was not present. It was not present. So these UV rays, they were directly falling on the earth. They were coming from the sun and without filtration they were falling on the earth. So these were the energy sources on the earth. Then radiations, then lightning. Yes, lightning, and then volcanic eruption. From these अर्थ वॉज गेटिंग एनर्जी और दीज वेयर द एनर्जी सोर्सेस ऑन द अर्थ. सो द अर्ली मॉलिक्यूल्स ऑफ हाइड्रोकार्बन अमोनिया एंड वॉटर दे शोड दे undergoes condensation, they undergoes polymerization, oxidation, reduction reactions, and as a result of these reactions, important molecules that which were responsible for the formation of living things were formed. Which were that molecules? They were monosaccharides. They were purines. Are you familiar with these words? Please watch again that heredity video in which that DNA, it consists of purines and pyrimidines. Okay, and then amino acids, these molecules were for amino acids. So these were formed. What two things we made? Now monosaccharides means sugar, the nitrogenous bases, amino acids from which proteins were formed. One thing remained, fatty substances. So write down here, what fatty acids and glycerols. Fatty acids and glycerol was formed. Now I think you got the idea. Now these substances were needed. Okay, for the formation of cell. So how that conditions were become favorable for the formation of living things that we are understanding. So this is the diagram of chemical evolution. See that from that clouds, rainwater is coming downside, then water bodies are formed. This is a sea. So inside the seawater, that methane, ammonia get dissolved. Then in second column we see nitrogen bases like purines, pyrimidines, then sugars, monosaccharides, then amino acids which were responsible for the formation of proteins, and fatty acids, from them lipids were formed. So all these chemicals were responsible for the formation of DNA and RNA. In that fourth column we see DNA and RNA. Students, we know that there are near about 20 types of amino acids. These amino acids, as they underwent polymerization reactions, proteins were formed. We know that many enzymes are also formed from proteins. So the formation of proteins was a landmark in the origin of life, and then after that nucleic acids were formed. And when nucleic acids were formed, we know that the nucleic acids along with organic and inorganic molecules, they formed first predominant or pre-cells. So the nucleic acid in the pre-cells had the capacity to multiply, but gradually it started directing series of chemical reactions like protein synthesis, and this led a significant step in the transformation of pre-cell into cell. So from this we understood that the first cell or primitive cell these cells were marine and heterotrophic in nature. Here we are finishing about formation of life. In next session we'll understand theory of evolution.